Okay, James Carville, Bristol, we find out, is 5 months pregnant. Is this an issue?
No, obviously this can happen in any family, and Governor Palin had absolutely nothing to do with this. Obviously, the family is acting honorably, and I can't imagine that this could affect somebody's vote. It has absolutely nothing to do with her lack of experience or anything else. This is just something that happens in families. It's a very human thing.
Does it say anything, Congresswoman Bachmann, about Senator McCain?
I think what this says about Sarah Palin is that she is a very consistent woman. She's very strong pro-life, because we all know that. She carried her final child, Trig, to term. He has a Down syndrome baby. And now when her daughter is in a situation with an unplanned pregnancy, there's Sarah Palin with her husband standing right behind her daughter. The daughter's going to be marrying the father of her unborn baby. And this is a family that's coming together. It's the news that no parent wants to hear, but the Palins are acting in such a loving, compassionate way with their daughter. And I know they're going to handle this in a beautiful way. It shows great judgment on the part of Sarah Palin.
James,
my family, I have five sisters. They're all pro-life to the core. And they all would act in exactly the same way. That's not the question. The question is, why would she be running for vice president? I mean, this woman is almost absent qualifications for the job. I mean, I'm willing to concede to the whole world that she's a very committed pro-life person, that she's an honorable person, that she's a good mother. But that's not the issue before the American people right now.
Well, the issue before the American people, Larry, if I can jump in, is Sarah Palin and her qualifications. She easily has more qualifications than Senator Obama and Senator Biden put together if you look at executive experience. She's been in an executive position for 2 years. She's made very tough positions. She's looked her own party in the eye, and she's said, enough with your corruption, and she says, throw the bums out. This is a woman who's delivered, and she knows how to get things done. I met with her up in Alaska last month when I was up visiting Anwar, had dinner with her, spent the evening with her. She is one sharp lady. People are going to be excited when they get to know Sarah Palin.
Congresswoman, are you saying she has more experience than Joe Biden on the international scene?
No, I'm not saying she has more experience on the international scene. Certainly she doesn't. She has more executive experience than both of them. She's made tough decisions as an executive, and I think women all across America are going to love what they see in Sarah Palin. I was taken with her, and I know that a lot of American women will be. She's very strong, very tough, a committed, loving mother, but she knows how to be a good executive and how to take on her own party and how to make things happen. There's no reason why people won't understand this once they understand that people in Alaska, 85% of people in Alaska have a positive approval rating for Sarah Palin. The rest of America now will see why.
By the way, Barack Obama was asked about Ms. Bristol Palin's pregnancy earlier today. Let's watch a little of what he had to say.
I've heard some of the news on this, and so let me be as clear as possible. I have said before, and I will repeat again, I think people's families are off limits, and people's children are especially off limits. This shouldn't be part of our politics. It has no relevance to Governor Palin's performance as a governor or her potential performance as a vice president. And so I would strongly urge people to back off these kinds of stories. You know, my mother had me when she was 18. And, you know, how family deals with issues and teenage children, that shouldn't be the topic of our politics. And I hope that anybody who's supporting me understands that's off limits.
All right? Yeah. An unnamed McCain advisor is quoted on Reuters as saying the despicable rumors have been spread by liberal blogs, some even with Barack Obama's name in them.
I am offended by that statement. There is no evidence at all that any of this involved us. I hope I'm as clear as I can be. So in case I'm not, let me repeat. We don't go after people's families. We don't get them involved in the politics. It's not appropriate, and it's not relevant. Our people were not involved in any way in this. and they will not be. And if I ever thought that there was somebody in my campaign that was involved in something like that, they'd be fired.
James Carville, how about the issue of her preaching family values, abstinence, all of which seems broken by this incident?
Well, you know, she didn't do any, and anybody that, it's a humbling experience for any parent, and this is not her. I'm sure that this happens in families all the time. I just don't think it's a real issue. Now, one of the things that I understand is she never had a passport until she was governor. She's only been out of the country, but she went honorably to visit the troops in Kuwait and went to Germany. So I don't know how many times she's even been out of country, but it's supposedly that she had to get a passport to do that. And we're going to have her be vice president of the United States based on a 15-minute conversation she had with Senator McCain. She was the touted experience as mayor of this town in Alaska. This is a picture of the city hall. It looks like a bait shop in South Louisiana. All right, this is executive experience to be vice president of the United States, to be a heartbeat away from the presidency, to have to take over the country when we're fighting three wars, when we have the biggest credit crisis we've had in this country. I mean, in the entire Republican Party, this is the best that they could come up with. I mean, incredulous.
You know, Larry, I find those comments from James Carville actually offensive, and especially offensive to American women. There are a lot of very competent American women. Sarah Palin easily is a competent woman. She's proved herself in business. She's proved herself in politics. She has come up from nowhere to be somebody, and she's someone we can all be very proud of. She is one competent, tough cookie, and I think the American people are going to love her.
Congressman, I don't know how to tell you this, but I supported a woman for president of the United States and spent many hours on this very set supporting a woman of the United States. However,
and that's why I think a lot of American women are going to be delighted with Sarah Palin, because she exudes competence in everything she's ever done. She has a very good record, and she'll be proud to run on that record. Senator McCain hit it out of the park with this pick.
We'll come right back.